Great to see everybody. How's everybody doing today?
Doing, I'm
Great
doing
day. How about
great.
you, sir?
Good.
I'm doing fantastic. So good to talk to everybody. Luke, I'm going to start with you. I got to give you props. I love the fact that we have something for the entire family that everybody in the family can watch.
Thanks. That's definitely something we were thinking about when we made the show. Certainly, we wanted something the kids would like and then they could watch with their family. And the thing we couldn't have predicted was by the time the show came out, we would be living in a time when a lot of people were at home much more than they expected to be. So this was really one upside is that if everyone's going to be stuck at home, we have what we hope is a fun family experience for people.
Amadi, I want to ask you, what makes this being a part of this Ghost Rider, which is just phenomenal, what makes it special to you to be a part?
What makes it special to me is, it's so diverse and I feel that everyone's included. It's special that kids get to see themselves on TV. It's special that, they get to say, hey, like, they're cool. Like, they're just like me. I can do it too. I can read. I can educate myself, while having fun. That's definitely one of the most special parts to me.
Isaac, same question for you. And also, I'll add, what makes this magical for you? Because there seems to be like a lot of magic in this series. And I'll get to that point after you answer the question. I want to bring up something.
Okay. Just as Amadi said, it's just so diverse, and even just with the kids, like we're all from completely different families. We all have completely different personalities, so we often see that clash in the show. Just seeing Ruben's kind of just being the leader and the motivational speaker, and then you got Trevon being very cautious with things, and Donna always being on board, and then you got, I'm not trying to say names, but Curtis not really wanting to do anything. Yeah, I think it's just magical, even just with the VFX. It's a great storyline for kids, just with the learning and stuff, and it just allows for hope, and it's uplifting. It's just takes you out of what's going on in the world today. Just something, we just kind of need a light right now, and this is definitely one of them.
I completely agree with everything you both have said. Okay, the magic of this, I will admit, I'm not a big reader, but watching this made me want to go back and like read some of these books, revisit reading. So to me, that was the magic for me. So Amadi, I'm going to start with you, and everybody's going to get this question, including you, Luke. What is your favorite genre as far as reading goes?
I like all genres. I like nonfiction, fiction, poetry. I just finished a poetry book that my uncle wrote actually because he's a writer. I like all genres, but I definitely like mystery. This show has definitely made me want to tap in and miss mystery.
Me too with that. Isaac, same question for you. Your favorite genre to read?
See, personally, if I'm gonna be honest, I've never been a big reader, but I do like devotionals and just stuff where I can kind of just really just kind of just pick up on a good amount of things that I can really use in my day-to-day life. Yeah, devotionals. I think one of my favorite books is Huckleberry Finn. My teacher made me read it, and I didn't want to read it, but then it turned out to be one of my favorite books. So, yeah.
And Luke, I'm going to close with you. Your favorite genre?
I like big, fat, old British novels with tons of characters in it. Charles Dickens is probably my favorite. I just like getting immersed in a really rich world for like a long period of time. So then you really kind of feel like you've gone through something by the time you get to the end of the book.
See how educational we were today. Thank you all so much for your time. Have a
Thank
wonderful
you,
day. Stay
Dave.
safe. You too. Thank
Yeah,
you.
you too,
Take
sir.
care. Thanks.